Hi, Canton South students. It's that time again. Can you believe it? It's time to register for your classes for the 2013-2014 school year. Hard to believe that time is here. However, we do have to review some things, and I really would like you to remember these things for graduation as far as what your graduation requirements are. And I know that you know them, but let's just review anyway. You need 4 English, 4 math, yes, 4 math, 3 science, 3 social studies, a half a credit of health, a half a credit of phys ed, a half a credit of financial literacy, which is something new, that's for sure, and a full credit of a fine art, plus 4.5 electives, and that will equal the minimum. A lot of kids get more than that, I understand, but you need a minimum of 21 credits to graduate. I will tell you, some students meet that phys ed requirement in different ways. As a matter of fact, a lot of students take 2 physical education classes. However, if you are in a sport or are in the band for at least 2 seasons, that will give you a physical education waiver. Again, it's not a credit, but it does count toward graduation requirements.
Mrs. Scholl started to mention some of the things that are new this year, and we're going to talk about some of those in more detail. The first one that we're going to talk about is this full credit of fine art that is required. Don't panic. Some of you have the fine art already covered. One of the new pieces that goes along with this fine art requirement is that there is a fine art waiver now, similar to a phys ed waiver. The fine art waiver can be earned by any student completing 1 credit, so just 1 year even, of a career tech program. Those CTE programs, those career tech programs, will include any of the 2-year programs for the juniors and seniors that are, the culinary arts and graphic design, any of those types of programs, but it also will include any 1 year of Project Lead the Way Engineering, any 1 class of biomedical, a year in CBI, or 2 semesters in the High School of Business, which would equal 1 full credit. So there are several ways to earn that fine art waiver.
Okay, I'd like to take a few seconds and talk to you about some other new things that will be happening for the next school year. First of all, our acting class will now be called Musical Theater. But don't panic if you're not musically inclined. If you're interested in any area in drama, this could be a really fun class for you. Also, government, I look like Vanna White here, government will now be an all-year course. And as Mrs. Scholl talked about earlier, financial literacy, you will be required to have a half credit of financial literacy that can be met through taking either economics or wealth management. Also, juniors, your sciences will change somewhat. You will now have the options of taking biophysics or chemistry, and then your senior year, you will have the other science options. Your current senior teacher will recommend which science class you'll be taking, either biophysics or chemistry. And regarding changes in math, we will no longer have the integrated math courses. You can now take algebra, geometry, algebra 2A, algebra 2B, or algebra 2AB. I'm not going to take the time to explain all the differences between the algebra classes right now, but your math teachers will talk to you more about that.
While some things are changing as far as courses here at Canton South, some things are remaining consistent. And one of those is that academic honor diploma. Just a review, 4 years of English, 4 years of math, 4 years of science, which definitely include physics, 4 years of social studies. You need a full credit of a fine art, which, by the way, if you've earned that fine art waiver, doesn't count for this. You actually have to take the class. You need 3 years of a foreign language. You need a 3.5 GPA, and you need to earn on the ACT a 27 or on the SAT a 1210. Now, don't forget, you don't need to earn all these. You can earn 7 out of the 8 criteria. However, you must meet, again, 7 out of the 8. Now, the Career Tech Diploma of Honor is just a tad different, and I say just a tad because I really mean that. You still need to earn the 4 English, the 4 math, the 4 science. However, with that science, it doesn't need to be physics. It could be an advanced science, though, but it needs to have 4. You need the 4 social studies. With the Career Tech Diploma of Honors, you do not need the fine art. What takes the place of that, however, is your Career Tech program, so you keep that in mind. Still need the ACT or the SAT, and you need that GPA, though. So, again, something to strive for, and just remember those criteria. Very, very, very important. Okay, you know all this. You know what you need to do in order to graduate. You need to know your credits. So what are the steps we need to take to register? How are we going to get there? Mrs. Plaster, why don't you tell us?
I'm going to tell you. You're going to be getting a packet of information. Every student will get one, and part of that packet is going to be your transcript. That's the first step, is reviewing your transcript. Your transcript is going to show lots of information. It's got all of your grades. So, let's see the section behind me here. This is your grades, and it goes in order of completion. So, 9th grade for this student, 10th grade, and 11th grade. On the other side of the transcript, you've got your attendance up top. Then it shows your OGT scores right here, and then it shows your credits by year. So it shows all of the information that you really should need to determine where you stand in terms of graduating. We are also, and actually, when looking at that transcript, please be sure that you're not just looking at the names of the classes. We as counselors make this mistake sometimes, but it's very important to notice that you're passing the classes. This particular transcript has some D's and some F's. So if you just go down and start checkmarking based on the names of classes, let's see. If you just checkmark based on the names of the classes, you're going to think you've completed them all. But you need to make sure that you've actually passed the courses and met the requirements. This is absolutely crucial to building your schedule for next year, making sure that you have all the classes you need to be on track for graduation.
The second step in registering for classes is to complete a graduation checklist. In your packet that you're going to receive today, you will also you'll receive your transcript, but you'll receive a graduation checklist that looks like this. We mapped out for you all the requirements for graduation in the state of Ohio, and what you're going to do is you're going to take your transcript and you're going to get your graduation checklist and cross-reference, and again, pay attention to what you've passed. Put big old check marks by what you passed, circle what you need to take for next year, and make a plan for your next year's classes. The third step in the registration process is to sign up for your core classes first. Your core classes consist of your math, science, English, and social studies. Then you can pick your electives, but we want to make sure you get your requirements in first. The fourth step in the in the registration process is talk to your parents and guardians about your classes for next year. It's important that they're part of your educational plan. And then the fifth step is to make sure that you get teacher recommendations for the following classes. You're going to need teacher recommendations for, get out of the way here, all math classes, foreign language, pre-AP and AP classes, and let me note that pre-AP is what was formerly known as our honors classes, and then our junior science classes that we talked about before, either biophysics or chemistry. The way you get those recommendations is on the back of your scheduling card. There will be an area where your teacher can sign and make those recommendations.
Okay, we're going to start talking actually about how to register, and shortly we're actually going to be showing you the process of registering for your classes online. The first thing that you'll need to do once you have your packet of information is to read the registration card carefully. We've taken a lot of time to go in and, you know, we changed the names of the courses. You'll want to make sure that you pay attention to how much credit each course is. Once you've kind of laid out what courses you think you want to take, it's time to get your signatures from your teachers and from the parents or guardians. We've got to have those signatures because many of the classes depend on a teacher recommendation. After you have all of the signatures and your choices made, you'll log on to the website, and again, we'll be showing you how to pick your classes online. After you've completed online registration, you'll turn your registration card into our office by February 15th, and be sure that you come and see us. Let your counselor know if you have questions about your classes. We can help you with that process. Just so you know, the online registration is going to be open from Friday, February 1st, through Friday, February 15th. Important to note that your usernames and passwords are case sensitive. They have to be typed in exactly as you see them on the paper or it's just not going to work. You have to register for a minimum of 5 classes, or minimum of 5 credits, I should say. So whether it's full year or a bunch of semester classes that add up, it will not even let you register unless you get to the minimum 5 credits required. And again, I want to emphasize, if you need our help, rather than putting it off and not getting it done, just come and see us and we will meet with you to help you get it done. This is the website. We will have a link to it from our website, from the high school website, but to register for classes, this is the website that you will go on to. And again, we'll be showing you how to do this in just a minute.
And just adding on a little bit to what Mrs. Hutzer said, I remember last year kids had a heck of a time with that, with their password trying to register. So read it very carefully. A lot of times those zeros look like the letter O, and again, we're here to help. So make sure you utilize this. It's really important. Another thing, though, I really want you to think about for a lot of students, juniors and seniors, remember it's just for juniors and seniors, is taking those dual credit courses. We are so fortunate, again, to be teamed up with Stark State, and we can offer, again, dual credit, where you get high school credit and your actual college transcripts begin. However, a lot of steps you need to do. Sophomores, you already did it. You took that Compass test before Christmas break. Just as a reminder, there are certain minimum scores you need on the Compass test to take some dual credit courses. And just as a quick summary of that, to take any of the math courses, you need to have a 55 on the algebra part. Not the pre-algebra, not the college algebra, but you need a 55 on the algebra. To take the English courses, you need a 70 in writing. And the other courses have different numbers attached to it, but those are the two main ones. If you have any questions, particular questions about the dual credit, come down and ask us. We know we can give you some of the information, more detailed information. As a matter of fact, there's a whole other registration process you have to do after you sign up, even online. Just as a review of the actual dual credit courses we have four English courses. We have Comp 1, Comp 2, we have a British Literature, American Literature. We have pre-calculus, we have college algebra. We have something new that's not even on this slide, it's so new. It's actually an online medical terminology class. We also have computer applications, and we're also blessed to have a variety of welding courses to offer too. Again, if you're interested in those, make sure you sign up when you go online, and then I'll follow up with you later as far as what other details you need to do. And that basically is for Stark State, but we'll get you that information later. Couple random things. Sophomores, we're going to be talking to you about HOBE. HOBE is a leadership conference just for sophomores. It's about Hugh O'Brien. He's the one who founded it. Again, we'll be getting you some information about that. And we are allowed to send one sophomore to be our Canton South representative. Girls and Boys State has been around forever. Again, we're very fortunate to partake in that also. And you will get hands-on information at the junior class meeting regarding the Girls and Boys State. There will be paperwork to fill out and to turn back to me, but it's a great opportunity for events that will be happening in late May and early June. Great opportunity, and I hope you consider signing up for those. Again, just to wrap up, registration, please take it seriously. It's so important to choose your classes wisely. It's so very, very, very important to not just sign up for what your friends sign up, but what's right for you. For that, don't forget, like Mrs. Huster said, the registration does open on February 1st online, but it closes. When I say close, it closes. That computer shuts down. So if you go on February 16th thinking no one will know, we will never get that information. So again, make sure you do that prior to February 15th. And also, once you go online and do all that, you hit that submit, you can't go in and make changes. You might think you made the changes, but we'll never get it. So after you submit your information for registration, if you change your mind, you have to see us. Again, if you don't, we'll never know. So with that, please give registration a serious thought. It's really vital that you pick the right courses for your academic success. And graduation is really right around the corner. So again, thanks for listening to us. This is kind of a new endeavor for us putting it online. We are having fun with it. But hopefully, if you have any questions, you can always rewind us and take a look if you need to hear that information again. So thanks, and good luck in choosing your classes for next year.
Okay. Once you've clicked on the link, which will again be on the Canton South High School website, you're going to see a login page. Each of you, as part of your packet, has been given a username and a password, which again, I have to emphasize that must be typed in case sensitive. So if it's lowercase on your paper, it's got to be lowercase, and if it's uppercase on your paper, it's got to be uppercase, or I guarantee you it will not log in. Here's where you type in your username and password. This is the screen you should see when you click the link. You click login. That's your first step. Once you're in, you're going to see this screen. It's got your personal information up top, and then you've got your course requests screen. What you need to do next is to move down to this area, and here where it says course groups and it says to display standard courses, you must pull down to the third option, display standard courses and course groups, for all of the options to be available. Secondly, you must click this box, include completed courses. This will do two things. It will make sure to highlight the courses that you have already taken so that you know and you're reminded of that. And secondly, that allows students who are in band or choir, video production, some of the classes that you might take more than once, it allows those courses to be eligible for you to sign up for again. So that's the second big step, is this checkbox. Then you'll click search. When you click search, what should pop up is a list of all of the courses that are available for choosing. So you must scroll down, and you'll start to see them all by here's the course code, which your registration guide has. Here's the course name, which also the registration guide has. Now, please forgive me, there are still some changes that will be made by the time you're able to log in and sign up, but you'll see an accurate list after February 1st. What you do to pick your classes is simply put a check mark in the boxes on the left. So let's just say that this student is ready for the third year of biomedical engineering, is going to take college and career ready as an elective. Here's an example of a class that this student has taken, that's why it's highlighted. But musical theater, which is also known as our acting course, this is a class that you might take more than once. So he can still go ahead and pick that class. Then he needs to pick an English. We'll pick English 4. Here again are some of the classes that this student has already taken for credit, so you'll know that those are completed, and most of those you cannot take again. So you'll skip over the math classes you've already taken and maybe pick the next math class. So once I've picked the classes I want, scroll all the way to the bottom. Down here at the bottom is where all the course groups are listed. So for freshmen, this is where you'll find the sophomore group, whether it's going to be the sophomore just regular group or your sophomore pre-AP group, or this is also where you'll find the high school of business groups. Once you've chosen your courses, you click down here at the bottom, Request Selected Courses. What this will do is pull up the classes to the top of the page that you have chosen. You'll notice here it says student pending, which means those requests have not been approved. It shows you how many credits each of your courses is worth. You click review requests. If you think you're done, click review requests. And here's where it's going to show you then your final opportunity to submit. Now, at this point, the student has not chosen enough to meet the 5 credits minimum. If you remember during the PowerPoint, we spoke about having to have a minimum of 5 credits in your schedule. Well, this student has only chosen 4. So even if it's a senior and he has his English 4 and he has his Algebra 3 and Trig chosen, and that might be all he needs actually to get to 21 credits. But again, everybody has to have 5. So you don't have the option to submit. In this case, he'll cancel. He'll get back to this screen, click search so that the courses can be pulled up again, and he needs to pick a few more options. So we're going to pick, we'll pick an art elective, digital photography, and we'll also pick an additional science. Anatomy and physiology is a senior level science. Again, now you can request those selected courses. Here's now his new full list and all of the credits and the fact that they're still pending. He will review requests. Here it shows that he's got 5.5 credits, so that does fall within the range, 5 to 9. And now we have the option to submit requests. I want to make sure that I emphasize, once you hit that button, submit requests, you cannot get in and change your requests again. Your username and login becomes invalid as soon as you submit your requests. If you need to make a change after that point, please come down and see your counselor. Also, if you have chosen all of these and you know for sure these are what you want and you click submit requests, the next step is to bring your completed registration card down to the student services office and turn in your card. Please don't turn in your card until you've done it online. If you're having trouble getting in online, just bring your card to your counselor and we will help you get those requests in. That is not a problem. But if your card gets put in the box, we will assume you also have those requests in online. So here we go. We're going to submit this student's requests, and those are now officially his requests for senior year. Hopefully that all makes sense. If you have any questions, come and see your counselor. Again, registration's open February 1st to February 15th. It will close out at midnight on February 15th.